It was like Weary had gone through an eco challenge race. He had walked, he had gotten on a bus, he had walked some more, and when you see him come up the driveway, he's got a backpack and a hat, and he looks like a hiker. And he's weary, thirsty. Hey, sir, could you come back over here, please, and have a seat right on there? You seem to be in a hurry there. Go ahead, have a seat right there, please. Why are you in such a hurry to get over on the other side of the fence?
Oh, nothing. I thought I was looking for somebody, and that's all. I'm sorry.
And who were you looking for?
John Petterson.
John Petterson?
Yeah.
And why were you looking for John?
Well, I was going to talk about some business.
And what business was that?
I'm going to try to find a job somewhere, and I heard about John Petterson.
And why did you come to this house looking for John Petterson?
I had a phone call.
A phone call?
Yeah.
From?
John Petterson.
So you were just walking down the road and you thought that this fellow with the construction company lived in this house?
Somebody told me that he lived...
Somebody? Who is somebody?
John Petterson.
He had called you just out of the blue?
No, I think he had my number.
And what's your name?
My name is Michael.
He starts to get into this, well, I'm here to apply for a job, and I said, well, so you know the folks who live here? He says, no, but I knew that they were looking for somebody to do some work. And I said, really, what kind of work do you do? He said, well, you know, driveway work, resurface driveways and cement, stones and things like that. What this sounds like, Michael, is that you were coming here to have sex with John Petterson.
Why are you asking?
I'm asking you.
Don't you know?
I want to know.
I'm telling you what I came here for, and I don't have sex with anybody.
So you want to tell me the real story now, or you want to go with what you got?
He had called me.
He had called you, just out of the blue?
A long time ago.
Do you have Scott Pedersen's name written down?
I'm guessing I do.
You're guessing you do? So you never wrote down Scott Pedersen's name anywhere?
No, I have an address. I can leave an address. That's all I was planning to do. Just going to Scott Petterson. I can't leave no phone number, no address.
So you want to tell me the real story now?
No.
Your story doesn't make that much sense. Now, maybe I'm skeptical.
I don't know.
But it doesn't make
sense. I don't know who you are.
But I'm Chris Hansen.
I don't even know who you are.
And what's your name?
Don't you know?
I want to know.
I came in here. I was just now told that gate's open. Come on in.
And who were you looking for?
Don't you know?
John Petterson.
Yeah.
Now, if you have anything else you'd like to say for yourself, we'd love to hear it. If not, you're obviously free to leave and go on your way.
I'm not doing anything. Now, if there's not, it's Scott Petterson.
Do you have Scott Petterson's name written down?
No, I have an address. I can leave an address. That's all I was planning to do. Just going to Scott Petterson. I can't leave no phone number, no address.
The reason why I'm so curious about all this is that I'm Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC, and we've been doing a story on computer predators, adults who go online to try to meet John Petterson.
I don't have sex with anybody.
He maintained until the very end of the interview that he was just a dusty, determined traveler who came from a long ways away to try to get honest work.
What's that person's name?
Scott was supposed to be here, and he didn't mention his name. I just said, look, it's Scott.
He's Scott.
The guy I was supposed to meet, I was told.
You work construction?
I was looking for any kind of job.
You don't work right now?